HaKadosh Boker Tov, we're going to continue Shavuot Tov, we're going to continue on Daf Kof Amud Aleph, so page 100, A1, okay? By Rava, Rava comes and he asks the following question. Egoz bekli ukli tzaf al gebemayim. When you have an egoz, you have a walnut, okay, which is inside of a utensil. And, right, when the walnut is in the utensil, it says over here, right, the kli is on top of water. Do we say that the walnut is considered munach already there? And therefore, it's considered like an akidah to do with hotzah, which means if you took out the walnut, it's considered akidah, it goes as linen, going after those walnuts, and it's actually, it's resting there. Well, maybe batar kli as linen. Do we go after the utensil? And at the end of the day, since the utensil, it's not actually standing anywhere. For teku, we do not actually or not. So, second, Rabbi Yochanan ben Nuri v'Rabbanan. We're not talking about silat tuma from oil tuma v'nagat ful yom b'shemen and a tvul yom. Remember, tvul yom had time to become pure. He didn't wait until the night. He's called the tvul yom. Remember, shem chibur is the oil of one. He says, bor b'shut rabim amuka asara. So imagine right now you have a bore with Rishut Rabim. You have a pit in the Rishut Rabim. Now it's going to be the depth of 10 tvachim, the width of 8 tvachim. Okay? And you threw this type of like a carpet inside of it. So it says, chayav, you're going to be chayav. However, though, if the machelet, right, is being divided from one side to another, this was the egoz on top of the utensil in the Rishut Rabim. No, there's not enough light. One second. Sorry. Here. This is the egoz on top of the utensil in the Rishut Rabim on top of the water. And now here's the machzelet that you split it up, which means here you have 8 tfachim, but you use the machzelet as like a mechitza. So that's what we just said. Chilka b'machzelet, you're going to be patur. It says, why? Because putting the machzelet, it took away from the board the din of Rishut Yachid. Okay? So la abaye de pshita le de machzelet mevatla mechitza. According to abaye, that he says that it's obvious that it's going to be mevatel the mechitza. Kol shekeno, the more so chulya de mevatel mechitza. That if you're going to have chulya, right, which is basically, let's see if it has in your picture. No. No. So kol shekin, the chulia is going to be mevatel mechitza for the place of the anacha. Because for sure, when you're going to be mevatel the afar in its place, which that's the chulia, for sure it's going to be mevatel. But according to Rabbi Yochanan, the mibay le chulia, but if Rav Yochanan had this safek by chulia, which is by the earth that is there, kol sheken, all the more so that by machzelet, it's not going to be a mechitza, and therefore you're still going to be chayav. Okay? V'am Rabbi, and Rabbi says, bor b'shut rabim. When you have a pit in the Rishut Rabim, amuka asara l'chavar arba'a melamayim. Right? So what happens right now if it's going to be the 10 tfachim tall and the 4 tfachim wide, and it's going to be full of water? So it says, "Vezerak letocha," you threw it inside of it. So he says, "Chayav," you are going to be chayav because of achnasa. La perot vezerak letocha patur. If it's full of fruits and you threw something inside of it, you're going to be patur. Why? Because since the fruits fill it up, it's not considered a bor. So the Gemara is going to ask, "Why not?" My tama, right? What's the reasoning? It says, "Ma'im lo mevatel mechitzata." Water does not mevatel the mechitza. Perot are mevatel the mechitza, which means perot are considered mitzamtzamim et amidot. They consider that it filled up the space, and therefore it doesn't have any midah. It doesn't have any space in order to be considered reshut yechid. Okay, Tanya Miach, you also learned the exact same thing in a braita. Zorek mina yam. If you threw it from the mina yam istaria, from the sea to an istaria, or from the istaria to the yam, you're going to be patur. Shimon Omer, Shimon says, "In yeshu mekom shazara kamok asara v'rachav rabah chaya." Is the picture. This is a istaria. Istaria is a Rishut Rabim. Okay, and then you threw it into the sea. So whether it's here into the sea or the sea into here, you're going to be That's what he says here. The first Mandamar says you're going to be patur because it's a Carmelite. Right? It's only the Rabbanan. However, the Rabbi Shimon says if you have this in the sea, which is going to be the 10 tfachim depth and 4 tfachim wide in the actual water, so then you're going to be chayav when you threw it into here. Okay? That was until the Mishnah. Okay? Says the Mishnah. After we were talking about in the beginning about throwing an utensil from one reshut to another reshut, we're going to now zrika to do with going four amot into the reshut rabim. Says the Mishnah, dafkuf amud alef, hazurek arba amot bakotel, if you threw a utensil four amot and it went inside of a wall, so the malama sarat fachim, if it was above 10 fachim from the ground, hazurek ba'avir, it's like you threw it in the middle of the airspace. So here's the picture. Right? Zarak lemalam ha'asarat fachim v'alecha v'nacha b'chor shkoshu in the wall. But again, this is talking about that it's above the 10 tfachim. Okay, so it went into the wall. So he says, so as long as it's above 10 tfachim, it's like you threw it in the air. Lemata me'asarat, but if it was less than 10 tfachim, because zorek paritz, it's like you threw it on the floor. Shazorek paritz arba amot chayav, if you threw it four amot on the reshut rabim and it landed on the floor, you're going to be chayav. Says the Gemara, v'halonach. So one second, if it went into the wall, so therefore it never landed anywhere. Right? So Rabbi Yochanan says, v'dvila shmina shanin. We're talking about like, you remember the dvila shmina, which was like the fig dish or the cake that it sticks on the wall. So since it's stuck on the wall, right, that's, you don't need it to, it's not that it landed, it did land. It landed and it got stuck to the wall. So Amar Rav Chiya, says Rav Yehuda, name of Rav Chiya, Zarak lemala ma'asara ve'alcha v'nacha b'chol kol shu. So if you threw it above 10 tfachim and it went into a hole into the wall, okay, that the hole itself does not have 4x4 tfachim. So banu l'machloke Rabbi Meir v'Rabbanan. So that was a picture that I showed you. That itself is the machloke between Rabbi Meir and Rabbanan. According to Rabbi Meir, that he says, chokekin lashlim, that we look as if to say that the wall is made a hole in it and it became like an entrance, so therefore it's still going to be chayav, a shiru mezuzah. Yichayev, it should be chayav. But according to the rabbis, en chokekin lashlim, but we don't do this, so then what happens is, lo mechayev, you shouldn't be chayav achatat. So basically, they want to try to compare it to ilchot mezuzah. Do we compare it to ilchot mezuzah that you'd be chayav, right, in a mezuzah or not, and therefore you should be chayav that he went into a domain or not. Okay, so Tanya Miyachi, we also learned in the Rabraita, Zarak lemala me'asara, if you threw it above 10 tfachim, ve'alcha ve'nacha bechor kolshu, and it landed inside of a hole, so it says, abimim mechayev v'chachamim putrim. So it's exactly, that's what it is. That's a machlok between abimim and chachamim. So Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Rav, says Rav Yehuda Amar Rav, tel, right, amitlaket asara mitoch arba'ah. When you have a tel, which is basically going to be a mount of earth, which is going to be 10 tfachim within 4 amot. V'nach al gabav, chayav. You're going to be chayav. Here's the picture. The 10 tfachim, tall, but within 4 amot. So within 4 amot, it became 10 tfachim tall. So in such a case, you're going to be, that means it came like, it went into a slant. But by the time it went 4 amot, it was already 10 tfachim tall. You're going to be chayav. Because it's considered a reshut yechid. Tanya Miyachi, we also learned in the Raita Mavoi. The same halacha would apply to a mavoi. Remember, the mavoi was like the thoroughfare which they used to pass through. It was like a side street. So, or it's equal to the reshut rabim. You don't need a lechi or korah to be metaltel in it. Why? Because the fact that it has this midron, it already makes it into the it's already made like a mechitza. And therefore, you don't need any other type of a thing to do it. Here it says the same thing. This was a picture, the same one that I showed you in the art school. And this is the one of the mavui. You have the reshut rabim and then the mavui coming up, or the opposite way. Right, the reshut rabim and going down. So in this case, you don't have to do any type of recognition in the Reshut Yechid, because that in itself is already a Reshut Yechid. So you just don't like you have to start making any type of a, you know, Lechi, Korah, the beams, and you know, like the Tzura Tapet, you don't have to do all those things. Okay? Okay, fine. Next Mishnah. Zarak betoch arba amot. If you threw in the Reshut Rabim within four amot, then it galgel chutz arba amot. So it landed, and then after landing, it rolled outside of the dalad amot. You're going to be patur. However, if you threw it four amot and then it rolled inside the dalad amot, you're going to be chayav. Because once you threw a dalad amot, you threw a dalad amot. Okay, so ask the Gemara, right? So this is again the picture. You threw a dalad amot and it rolled back. Okay, this is throwing the dalad amot and then it went out. Or the throwing dalad amot and it went back inside. Okay? So says the Gemara, the halonach. He says, 1 second. If you threw it outside of dalad amot and then it was nitkalgel within the dalad amot, but 1 second, but if it didn't land anywhere and it didn't stop anywhere, why would it be chayav? So Rabbi Yochanan says, "V'hu shenach al gabi mashu." It did land on something, right? So therefore, even though it went within the dalad amot, since the anacha was outside of the dalad amot, you're chayav. Tanya Miachi also learned the exact same thing in a braita. Zarak chutz arba amot. If you threw it outside of dalad amot, u'chavato aruach, and then a wind came nisato and brought it inside. And afterwards, you went and you put it outside, you're still going to be patur. Achasto ruach mashu, but if the ruach came and it stopped it, even though it didn't bring it in, you're going to be chayav. That means if the ruach stopped it in the air in a little bit, so then you're going to be chayav. So now says the Gemara like this, Amar Rava, Rava says, Toch shlosha, within three tvachim from the ground, according to the rabbis, tzarich hanacha, it does need Hanacha. It means that it should land on the ground. Because if you remember al gabi mashu on something, because if you remember according to the rabbis, we don't say kluta kimishum chadamim, which means we don't say that if it's in the middle of the air, it's like it's on the bottom. We don't say that. Okay, so yati minema v'kamala la shmaita. So Meimar was sitting and saying this braita, male, Ravina no Meimar. So says Ravina to Meimar, dafkufa mubet. Lo hainu matznitin, is that not our Mishnah, the exact same case of our Mishnah? V'amar Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yochanan says, v'u shenach al gabi mashu. But that's as long as it's landing on something. So Amalei, he comes and he says, Midgalgel kamarta. You're talking about Midgalgel. Midgalgel, if it's rolling around, then so falanuach, it's not going to, meaning the fact that the way that it's doing this, it's not going to land anywhere. Avalhai, but in this case, given the falanuach, since it is going to land, Afa gavdulonach, even though it didn't land right now, kamandana, it's like it landed. Kamashman comes to teach you, that's why Rava was coming to, we don't say that. But the Chachamim say that we do need it to land within three tvachim in order to be considered munach in the Reshut Rabim. Sorry. Okay.
Thank you.
Mishnah Dafkufa Mubet. Okay. Azorek Bayam Arba Amot. If somebody's going to throw an object in the river, in the sea, for Amot, you're going to be patur. Imaya Rekak Maim, if there was a, I don't know how you want to call it a Rekak, but it's like a body of water. And you have a Reshut Rabim going through it. Here just gives a picture. So you have water, but there's a Reshut Rabim in the water. So you threw something inside of it. Okay? So he says, in such a case, Reshut Rabim Alechebo, Hazorek Letocho, if you throw inside of it, Arba Mot, you're going to be Chayav. How much is it considered a body of water for this? It has to be less than 10 tvachim to be considered a Reshut Rabim. Okay? That's what we just said. Okay. Fine. Says the Gemara. Said one of the rabbis to Rava, Bishlema hiluch hiluch trezimne. I understand that when it's going to be twice mentioned that you went, Hakamashmanan comes teach you hiluch alidet dachak shmei hiluch, that when you're walking, even though you're going through a body of water, it's still considered walking. Tashmish alidet dachak lo shmei tashmish, but if you could use it alidet dachak, meaning using it in extenuating circumstances, it's not considered tashlish. Meaning for you to walk, even if it's going to be difficult for you to walk, okay, you're going to walk it. But if it's going to be that it's going to be tashmish, which is basically using it, it's very difficult to consider that you're able to use such a thing. Why did it say twice, rekak, rekak? In our Mishnah, it said it twice. It says rekak maim twice. Why? So it says the Gemara, one of them is bimot hachama in the summer, one of them is bimot hachama in the winter. And you need both cases. As if it was only going to teach us one of them, I would have thought only in the summer. But some people will walk through the pool of water just to become cold. But if it's going to be in the winter, in the raining season, you're going to tell me the raining season. Maybe because he's already dirty with water, he doesn't care going through more water. But in the summer that he's not dirty of water, he wouldn't just come and go through water. So because of that, that's why you needed both cases of the rakak. Abaye says, Itzich, we need it for another reason. Salkadait, I mean, I would have thought to say, Hanamila, one of these words, if it wasn't for a mot. But if it was for a mot, you would just go around it. I mean, if it's going to be for a mot, you wouldn't go around. But if it's mamash, you know, if it's more than for a mot, right? If it's going to be, right, that's what he says, going to be for a mot, you would go around it. So you're not going through it. If it's a little tiny puddle, you'll go right through it. But if it's a huge puddle, you would try to go around. Ravashi says another reason. Itzich. Sakadai Zamina, I would have thought to say, Animile Chadav Arba, only if it's going to be four Tfachim, right? He says, why? Avlecha Delovi is four Tfachim. He says, because if it's going to be like four Tfachim, it's like the Shut Rabim. Right? So you would just jump over it. He says, but however, though, if it doesn't have four Tfachim, if it's Pasile, you would just jump over, as it say. Right? You wouldn't go through it, you would just jump over it. Four Tfachim is not 32 centimeters. You could jump over 32 centimeters. As the Ravashi Tamir, Ravashi goes according to his reasoning, Dama Ravashi, Haiman de Zarik, Menacha Guda de Gam. If you're going to throw something and it lands, right, on a neset of a geshet, we're talking about like on a piece of wood on the bridge. Okay, so he says, Mechayev, you're going to be Chayav. Share Rabim Bo Kimbo, because the majority of people, they go on it. So for since a lot of majority of people go on it, so that's why it's considered Rishut Rabim. Okay, says the Mishnah. Mishnah, this is again the second Mishnah on Kufa Mubet. Hazorek mina yam le yabasha. You're going to throw from the yam to the yabasha. Right? We're talking about by the way, just so you have the pictures. Here we're talking about the jumping over it. Nifsa pasile. Here we're talking about that you threw it from over here to Aguda in the middle. So since the majority of people go over it, it'll be chayav. Okay, and now we're talking about here. Hazorek min hayam leyabasha, that's over here. Okay, so when you're going to throw from the yam to the yabasha, okay, it says like this. Umin hayabasha leyam, or from the yam to the yabasha, minas yam lesfina, whether it's to the river, to the sea, to the boat, or the boat to the sea. And it's fina lechavetar, from one boat to another boat. Patu, you're going to be patur in all these cases. Because they're all considered karmelites. It's not like reshut rabim. Sfinot kshurot zubazo, right? However, if you have boats which are tied to each other, okay, etaltalim izolazo, so you're allowed to transfer from one to another, as long as there's no fort fachim in between the boats. Avalimene kshurot, but if they're not kshurot, afal pi shemukafot, even though they're right beside each other, you're not allowed to travel, to transfer from one to another. Okay? Itman, it was stated. Sfina. We're talking about a boat. Ravuna Amar, Ravuna says, Motzim Hemena, you're allowed to take it out from it. Ziz Kolshehu. For example, a makel katan, a small little tiny like pole. Okay, and you're allowed to put it on. Umemale. Avchasta. Let's see if you have a ear. Ziz Kolshehu. Okay, there's the boat. You take out a little tiny pole, okay? That the pole is the aleph. Okay, a little tiny pole, and there's no problem. Okay? So he says, Rav Una Amar, Ziz Kol Shehu Mimale, right? And then you could fill up water. You're allowed to make a mukaf mechitzot, 4x4 tfachim, and then you're allowed to fill it up. Okay. Now it says, Ravuna amar motzi emena kziz kol shum emaleh. Ravuna just says that you just take out a little tiny pool and then you could fill up water. Kasavar karmalit me'ara mashkinan vavira mekom turiu. Says because according to him, it's a karmelit in the water. Me'ara mashkinan, we actually do it from the water. Vavira, so it comes out of the avir, which is above ten tfachim, is makom tur. Uvdinu diziz nami lulbay. So technically, you wouldn't even need this pole sticking out at all. But rather, there should be a eker, something recognizable, in order that you shouldn't just stam carry from a karmelit to a normal reshuta yachid. But al chastav rabba ravuna amre, and kamra v'chastav ravuna, they say, no, semakom arbaum imalek, asavadeh hold, karmelit, misfat mayan ashkina. It starts from the body of the water. So maya ara samichta, and the karka ave is very, very thick. Okay, so therefore he says, so you lo avid mekom arba. So if you're not going to make a place of arba arba, kametatem mekabel shu yachid. You're carrying from the kamelit to the shute yachid. Okay, so that's why the machloki was: do you just take out a pole, or do you have to do like this, like a place which is 4x4 tefachim, and then you do it from within it? You see, like from within the place, you have to come, you have to take the water. Okay. So amale Rav Nachman le Rabba Ravua. Says Rav Nachman to Rabba Ravua. He says, Ravuna da Amar, according to Ravuna, he says, you just stick out a pole, memale, zimni dileka asara, vekametatem, vekametatem, sometimes you're not going to have 10 tfachim, depth, right? And then what's going to happen is, you're being metaltel from a karmelit to reshut yachid. So Amarle, so he answers him, gamrinan, ten sfina me'alecha b'chum esara, we know that a boat cannot be going on something which is less than 10 tfachim. 80 centimeters, right, is the minimum that you need in order for the boat to start, you know, driving on top of it. Right, nowadays, if you go to the fancy boats, you see it also. And it tells you over here, you have the depth of each place. And many times, boats, they know what their depth level is. They cannot come and go in very shallow places. Right, you have there's certain places in Hallover Beach over here. When you go up the bridge on the left side, when you're going towards North Miami Beach, right, you could see on the left side the boats. The big boats cannot go in the middle because since it's so shallow, right, it would crash. It would crush the entire bottom part, right? So therefore, what it has to do is that it has to stay far away, and then they take a little tiny raft or whatever it is, and they go to the shallow areas. But only the smaller boats could go to the shallow areas, because if not, it's impossible. Okay, so says the Gemara, the Hamorsha Itla. He says 1 second, but the Sfina has a little tiny blita. Like a little nose, right, that goes above the ground. Let's see if it says it here. Yeah, this is the Morsha. The Morsha is the little tiny nose over here. That's the Morsha. The nose. Okay. So he says, right? So if so, even though the Kakita Sfina cannot go on the water, but from the nose you could do it. But you could go. So you could go right before it becomes ten tfachim, and then right down there, you go down. Right? Here it gives you the picture. I'll show you again the picture. This here, the picture is where you have a stone. So the boat itself cannot get there, but the nose could be on top of it. And then you're like fishing on top of that. So it doesn't have the ten tfachim. Okay? Samar of Safra, Rav Safra says, Geshusha azekama. Right? Always people go beforehand, right, with maklot aluchim in order to make sure that the boat could actually get there. Because if not, right, so it's very interesting. You have like people like, you know, swimming in front, making sure that there's nothing that's going to make the boat crash. I guess they would only do that in very shallow waters, obviously. Not going to do that in the middle of the sea. Okay? So, Amar le Rav Nachman v'yisal le Rav Chiya Barami. He says, Rav Nachman v'yisal le Rav Chiya Barami. Rav Chassan, Rav Avuna, Damni, Yael, Samakom, Arba, Mele. According to the Shita, Rav Chassan, Rav Avuna, they say, just you make a 4x4 and you fill it up. Shofchin didei hechashadi leu. He says, how are you going to throw? Right, how are you going to throw it inside? If you're going to tell me that you're going to throw it inside, so then it's going to become disgusting. Well, you're going to drink from there. Obviously, you're not going to drink from there anymore. So the answer is the Gemara, the Shadi Lehu Adafna the Sfina. You're pouring the water on the sides of the boat, and then the boat, it goes back down into the sea. So it says the Gemara, Ve'ayika kocho, at the end of the day, it's coming from your strength, which means that you're throwing these shofchim at the end of the day down into the sea, but it's coming from your reshut. That's you're doing it. So answers the Gemara, kocho bekarmeli lo gazru. Even since it's only coming from your koach, from your strength, there, if it's going to be in a drushutor abim, you're going to be chayav. But in a karmelit, which is right, which is really like, you know, it's in between, it's a no man's land. So then they weren't so strict in there. So minat teimra the time. How do we know this? The time we learned in the Braita, sfina emet alim tzuchol liyamelom minam yatzuchol. We said that you're not allowed to carry from the sea to the boat or the boat to the sea, right? So it says Rav Yehuda Omer, Rav Yehuda says, right? Amuka asara v'engavo asara. If it's going to be 10 tfachim, right, deep, but it's not going to be 10 tfachim above the water. You're allowed to do it from inside of it to the sea, but not from the sea to the water. And then we're going to have to obviously ask why. Okay, so Bezrat Hashem, we continue tomorrow.